After 6 seasons of Power, we saw a bloodbath in the final season. Many wished the show would never end. All we can now say that the wait is finally over. Power Book 2 is hitting our TV screens in September, and in this video I'm talking all things Tommy related and my predictions for Power Book 2. Let's get straight into it. First things first, I'm going to talk a bit about Tommy, because a few of you guys commented on my last video and on my video on Power Book V-Force, which is Tommy's spin-off, and I'll put a link to them in the description down below and in the comment section if you want to go check those videos out too. But the question was, are we going to see Tommy in Power Book 2? And I think yeah, we will. Only in flashbacks. I'd be really surprised if we see Tommy after we saw him split and leave for LA at the end of Power Season 6. I think a lot of people think that Tommy will appear in the spin-off because Courtney Kemp teased it, saying will Tariq ever see Tommy again? Oh, you gotta watch Power Book 2 for that answer. And she didn't say no or yes, she left it kind of open, but because of the way she said it with her enthusiastic tone, it kind of got me thinking whether we'll see him play a small part in Power Book 2. This is why I think he'll appear in a flashback or two with Ghost potentially, because I think Tariq is gonna have a real tough time dealing with being all on his own. He's gotta step up and be a real man now than provide for his family. I think Tariq killing Ghost is gonna haunt him, and we'll see Tommy and Ghost in a few flashbacks throughout Power Book 2. Because let's not forget, Tommy was a father figure to Tariq, but that's how I think Tommy will appear in Power Book 2, but of course it's just my opinion. If you guys have any other thoughts, then let me know in the comment section down below. But what are my actual predictions for Power Book 2? We know it's kicking off 72 hours after Tariq shot Ghost. There's a funeral of some sort, and we're not 100% sure that it's Ghost's funeral, but I'm pretty sure that it is. It doesn't mean that he's dead though. The casket could be empty. For all we know, Ghost could be locked up somewhere. It just wouldn't surprise me if Ghost was alive. But talking to Tariq, from the new teaser, we see that he's going to be living a double life. He's going to have to juggle his college life, as well as making money to pay for Method Man, who's Davis McClane. He's going to be playing Tasha's lawyer, and he's not going to be cheap. We're going to see Tariq hustling, and in the teaser, he even says he's going to have to do anything to help his mother, and we know what that means. He's going to be hustling in the game, and I think he's going to be working for some people and find himself in real trouble, and I think that might even be working for Mary J. Blige. And I mentioned it in my previous video, for those of you who missed it, this image just here symbolizes what we're going to see from Tariq. We're going to see the top half, where he's at college living a normal life, and in the bottom half, where he had to live a life like Ghost did. We're going to see Effie return, and that's going to play a role in Tariq's love life, because there's an unfinished storyline between the two for sure, because of the way it finished in season 6 after Effie was the one that was responsible for Tariq getting expelled from Chote, and just how Angela was Ghost's weakness. I think Tariq falls for Effie, and that's what will land him in a lot of trouble. So we're going to see a lot of similar traits between Ghost and Tariq. But who is Effie? Now, I did a video on this a few days ago, and I'll put a link to it in the description and in the comment section down below, but I thought about a link where she could potentially be Kanan's daughter, because her and Tariq used to play chess. The only other time we see chess on Power was with Tariq and Kanan. Kanan killed Sean, and Effie said her brother was killed, so could she be Sean's sister and Kanan's daughter? Now, quite a few of you said that she's Mary J. Blige's daughter in my last video, and that makes sense as well. But what if her parents are actually Kanan and Mary J. Blige? So it's just something for you to think about, because the links and connections are there. And there were rumors that Ghost had a secret daughter with Blige, but that was instantly shut down by Courtney Kemp. Also guys, before I go on, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to this channel. I'll be releasing a lot more videos on Powers with reviews and breakdowns, so remember to subscribe. And with Mary J. Blige, what's her role going to be in Power Book 2? I think her presence is something that would be similar to Ghost. She comes from the streets, and her way of controlling and manipulating people is what we're going to see. Compared to Ghost, Ghost was a bit more from the books. Mary J. Blige is more streetwise, but she's going to be just as strategic and as smart as Ghost was. This is where I think she's going to use Tariq with the use of Effie. And I think Mary J. Blige is going to be ruthless in her approach to everything and anyone who gets in her way. In the new teaser we got, we saw Tamika interrogating Tasha, and she even questions how she knew Ghost would be alone. Someone else was there, and she says it was her son. She's going to try and break Tasha down, but there's no way that Tasha would give up Tariq. A mother is always going to do what it takes to keep her son safe. And she didn't just take the fall for Tariq just for her to give him up. And Tasha is no way going to crack. We saw in Power when she was being interrogated when Ray Ray was killed. Tasha doesn't crack. But just because she doesn't crack doesn't mean she won't slip up in her story, because Tasha screamed it's not true. And I can only assume that Tamika or Cooper Sacks have put the pieces together and said that they think that she's taken the fall for Tariq, and it was Tariq that shot Ghost. And let's not forget, Cooper Sacks is going to be all over this damn case. He knew that Tariq was at Truth the night Ghost was shot, but he can't place him there without placing himself at the scene of the crime as well. And I fucking hate Sacks, because he just never let go of Ghost, but now that Ghost is out of the picture, I might start to like Sacks, because I fucking hate Tariq even more. And we've got another hell of an actor, Method Man, who's going to be playing Davis McClane. He's going to be Tasha's lawyer, and he isn't just any normal lawyer, he's a famous lawyer, famous for taking on big cases, and he's not going to come cheap. And this is why Tariq is going to be hustling. This is where he says in the teaser, he has to do anything to help his mother, and it's the same how Tasha would do anything to protect Tariq. And in my opinion, Tasha's getting out of prison, and this is just my opinion guys, there's no leaked storyline or anything like that. I just think there's no way Tasha spends the whole of Power Book 2 in prison. This is how I think she manages to get out of prison, with the help of McClane, and it's going to be done legally. I can't see Tariq or Tasha master masterminding a Michael Scofield type of prison break, there's not a chance. I can't see that happening. And the new teaser finishes off with Tariq asking someone if they have a deal. And this is where I think he's either talking to Cooper Sacks or Mary J. Blige. The reason why I think he could be talking to Cooper Sacks is because they both know they were at Truth at the time Ghost was shot. And we've already seen Tariq blackmailing Cooper Sacks once before, so he might be making a deal with him to keep him quiet. But I also think that Tariq's gonna be working with Mary J. Blige, or for Mary J. Blige. She's got him right where she wants him on a shoestring, and I think he's gonna find himself in a lot of trouble while working for Blige, that's for sure. And Tariq's no ghost, so let's see what happens, because there's not much to go out there in terms of plotline to go by. They've been really tight-lipped about the story on Power Book 2, and even the teaser was only 20 seconds long. And they didn't give away much at all, so let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. Let me know what your predictions are for Power Book 2. I want to know what you guys think. Also, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to smash the thumbs up, like the video, and I'm going to be making a lot more reviews and breakdowns of Power, so if you haven't done so already, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.